I have given Maria permission to leave the Abbey for today.
I told you, Sister Berta.
But she was late.
Sister Sophia, they do not see eye to eye about Maria. How do you feel about her?
I love her very dearly, but she seems to be getting in trouble, doesn't she?
Exactly what I said.
Kettles and warm woolen mittens, round paper packages tied up with strings.
These are
When we enter the Abbey, our worldly clothes are given to the poor.
And what about this one?
Well, the poor didn't want this one.
This is what you would call a royal dress.
It belonged to our last postulant. I would have made my own dress, but I wasn't given time. I can't make my own clothes.
Good. I'll see that you be given some material today, if possible. Now, you will be in charge of my children. There are seven of them. You will find out how far they have progressed in their studies and caring for them. Each morning will be spent in the classroom, and each afternoon, they will reach. You will see that at all times they conduct themselves with orderliness and decorum. The first rule in this house is discipline.
Yes, sir.
This is your new Fraulein, Fraulein Maria. As I sound your signals, you will step forward and recite your name. Fraulein, your job is to listen and learn their signals so that you may call them as you want.
Liesl.
Friedrich.
Louisa.
Kurt.
Brigida. Marta. Gretel.
Now, Fraulein, let's see how well you listen to me.
I don't need to listen for them, Captain. What I mean is that I'll be with them all the time.
That is not the case. This is a large house and a large estate. They've been taught to come only when they hit their senses. Now, when I want you, this is what you will be.
Because I can never answer to a whistle.
That's nonsense. Everyone in this house answers to a whistle. I'll show you.
Yes, sir.
This is my wife, my butler, the new governess, Fraulein Marie.
Yes, sir.
This is my executive officer, Frau Schmidt, the new governess, Fraulein Marie. Please be sure to approve. I shall now leave you in charge.
Pardon me, sir, but I don't know what to call you.
You will call me Captain.
Thank you, Captain. I forgot to return this whistle, Captain. I won't be needing it, Captain.
Well, now that it's just us, could you each tell me your names and how old you are?
Now
you are. I'm Liesl. I'm 16 years old, and I don't need a governess.
Well, I'm glad you told me. We'll just be good friends then.
I'm Friedrich. I'm 14, and I'm a boy.
A boy? Why, you're almost a man.
I'm Brigida.
You didn't tell me how old you are, Louisa.
I'm Brigida. She's Louisa. She's 13 years old, and you're smart. I'm 9, and I think that dress is the ugliest thing I've ever seen.
Brigida, you mustn't say a thing like that.
Why not? Don't you think it's ugly?
Well, if I did think so, I wouldn't say so. I'm Kurt. I'm 11. Almost.
Well, that's a nice age to be. 11. Almost.
And I'm Marta, and I'm turning 7 on Tuesday. I would love a pink parasol.
Pink is my favorite color, too. And you're red. I'm going to tell you all something. I've never been a governess before.
You mean you don't know the first thing
about being a governess? No. How do I start?
Well, the first thing you have to do is to tell Father to mind his own business.
No, Louisa, don't. I like her.
What's in here?
My guitar.
What'd you bring that for?
For when we all sing together.
We both sing.
What do you mean you don't sing? Everyone sings.
What songs do you know?
We don't know any.
You don't?
No.
Well, now I know where I'm going to start. I'm going to teach you how to sing.
Start at the very beginning, a very good place to start. When you sing, you begin with A, B, C. When you sing,
Do re mi, do re mi, do re mi.
rising. Listen.
So do la fa mi do re.
Now you try.
So do la fa mi do re. So do la ti do re do. So do la ti do re do.
Together.
Thank you.
help.
You don't have to say goodbye this early. After all, your father isn't home.
How did you know my father wasn't home?
Oh, I have a way of knowing things.
How did you know 2 days ago that you would be here at just this time at night with a telegram for Franz?
Every night on this night, he gets a birthday telegram from his sister. Can I come again tomorrow night?
Rolf, you can't be sure you'll have a telegram to deliver for tomorrow night.
I did come here by mistake of a telegram for Colonel Schneider. Is he up in Berlin? No one's supposed to know that. Don't you tell your father.
Why not?
Well, your father is pretty Austrian.
We're all Austrian.
Some people think we should be German. We're pretty mad at those who don't think so.
Well, I'm sure I've forgotten all about it by the time father gets back. Don't worry.
The only one I worry about is his daughter.
Me? What?
How old are you, Liesl?
16. What's wrong with that?
You wait to forget what empty stays, holding to the light on. Your life is a empty place that men would want to light on.
Help her to tell me what she's up to.
I was out taking a walk and somebody locked the doors earlier than usual, and I didn't want to wake everybody up. So when I saw your window open, you're not going to tell Father, are you?
Thank you. You weren't out walking all by yourself, were you? You know, if we wash that dress out tonight, no one will notice it by tomorrow. Then this is going to stay between you and me. You can put this on. Now go in there and put this dress to soak in the bathtub and come sit on the edge of my bed. We'll have a talk.
I told you today I didn't need a governess. Well, maybe I do.
Oh, Gretel, are you frightened?
We won't see them.
Boys are brave. You boys weren't afraid too, were you?
No, we just wanted to make sure you were.
Was this your idea for the trip?
No, it was Kurt's.
That's the one I forgot.
Kurt. God
bless Kurt. What does it do then?
What? Well, maybe if we sing loud enough, you won't have to hear it. High on the hill was a little lake. Loud was the voice of a lonely company. Ghost in the town that was quite plain on her.
Make you do make
you lusty and the goat.
Desperate to find singers for the Celtic Festival. But you like it here.
Oh, well, we'd have to spend some time in Vienna. I have its estate to look after.
I thought that was a corporation.
It is, and I'm president.
You are the president of a corporation.
After all, I managed Heinrich's estate for years before he died.
I just can't see you sitting behind a desk.
Well, of course, I wear a business suit and smoke a big cigar.
Excuse me, sir. Herr Detweiler left his coffee.
While he's telephoning.
He just finished.
Sorry it took so long.
Any luck?
How would you like this for the Karlsburg Festival? The best choir in all of Austria. The best mixed quartet in all of Europe. And the greatest soprano in the world.
Max, that's something I would love to hear.
So would I. All I've got up to now is a basso who isn't even perfumed up.
Max, you always come up with a good festival concert.
And why is that? Because my motto is never start out looking for the people you wind up getting. That's why I've been telephoning Rome, Stunden, London, Stockholm.
On Georg's cell phone?
Of course. How else could I afford it? Why do you think I'm up here?
I hoped it was because you liked me.
Oh, of course I like you. You live like a king. You have an excellent wine cellar.
Max!
What? I like rich people. I like the way they live. I like the way I live when I'm with them. Speaking of government, get over. Is there a cathedral around here?
That is our abbey, Nongren Abbey.
Do they have a choir?
Beautiful one.
Good. In the coming days, I'll have to go to all the towns and villages around here and check out all the choirs, quartets, singers.
You'll be here for meals, won't you?
Oh, of course. It was in a town about that size, Walton, where I discovered the St. Ignatius Boys Choir. In 1933, they won the festival, became very famous, and toured all over the world.
Oh, yes. Whatever became of them?
By the time the voices changed, they were rich enough to move to America. Who lives in that dilapidated castle down there? Rumpelstiltskin?
That is Baron Elberfield, the oldest family in the valley.
I'd like to meet him. I'd like to meet all of your friends. Taylor, why don't you have a dinner for me? Nothing much, just something lavish.
I wouldn't know who to invite. These days it's hard to know who's your friend and who's your enemy.
This isn't a good time to be making enemies. Let's make some friends.
I can't understand what's happened to the children.
You're not worried about them, are you?
They should have been here to greet you.
It couldn't have been an intentional flight. After all, they've never met me before.
Forgive me. I'll go try to find them now.
So, have you made up Georg's mind yet? Is he going to marry you?
Oh, yes. He hasn't admitted it yet. There seems to be something standing in his way.
Do you know what that is?
No.
I do.
What?
It's simple. It's money.
Money?
Yes. He's rich, and you're rich. In all the famous love affairs, the lovers have to struggle. The girl wins away upstairs, the lovers star and snuggle. The famous girl's fortress is seen to have a fear of ones who are very rich, you very seldom hear of.
There is not a sign of them.
You haven't gone.
How can love survive?
Thank you.
everything with you too. I don't know your names yet, but it doesn't matter. I'm sure I'll have plenty of time to learn them.
My name is Marta.
It is not. I'm Marta. She's Louisa.
You're right. I don't know my own children.
And they want so desperately to know you. Once I've gone...
No, I want you to stay.
If I can be of any help.
You already have. You brought music back tonight. But I've forgotten.
Came back to congratulate you.
Thank you.
The captain was really moved.
Yes, he seemed pleased. He asked me to stay on with the children.
You're staying on?
Until September.
September?
Yes. Then I go back to the Abbey.
The Abbey?
I'm going to become a nun.
Oh, how nice. We'll get back to the Abbey. Think of us.
I'll pray for you.
Why not?
She's a nursemaid.
I don't think of her that way.
I don't mind it.
not.
Elsa, tell him why not.
Max, you can change in a hurry.
Yes, Max, we could use this.
Grouch traitor, they're talking about you out there.
Come on, Damon, I've been dodging these two before now. Brigida, have you seen your father?
Good evening, Fraulein Maria.
Good evening, Air Dead Father. It's nice to see you.
Yes, we were going to.
I knew it. Grouch traitor didn't have a headache. She just wanted to get out of the party. She was faking.
Brigida, you shouldn't say things that you don't know to be true.
But I do know. I heard her tell Bobby she's been talking to people all night.
That doesn't mean that she didn't have a headache.
It's very important that you even like Grouch traitor.
I like her all right.
Why are you so important?
Well, I think she's going to be your new mother.
What? Fraulein, no! Father couldn't possibly marry her! No, he couldn't!
Boy, why couldn't he?
Because he's in love with you!
Now, Brigida, that's just the kind of thing!
You must know that!
No, Brigida!
Don't you remember the other night when you were all sitting on the floor singing that 808 song he taught us? You laughed at him for forgetting the words, but he didn't forget the words! He just stopped singing to look at you! And the way he talks to you, the way his voice sounds, and when you were dancing with him just now, you're in love with him too!
Brigida, no!
One more dance, girl, and it's off. Oh, Fraulein Marie, I won't be dancing with the children tonight. We'll be downstairs. It's already set up and it's all great. But you will have to change. Wear the dress that you wore the other night while we were all singing. It was lovely, so.
Shall I announce dinner, Captain?
Oh, no, not yet. I wanted the children to say goodnight. I wanted them to sing it the way they did last night.
No, Elsa, not you.
Please, Gail, the way they did it was so sweet.
That was one of them.
For me.
Let's go, Kenjo!
Say goodbye.
I leave and heave a sigh and say goodbye.
Elsa, they're extraordinary.
How did Maria taught them how to do it?
To think I've been searching all over Austria for something like this for the College Park Festival, and I find it right here, Mom.
Wait a minute, Max.
Seven children in one family.
Max, Georg didn't even want the children to sing in front of the guests tonight. I had to persuade him.
Then you have influence. Elsa, you have to convince the captain to let his children sing at the festival.
Max.
It's for Austria. And it wouldn't be any harm either.
Thank you.
That is the problem.
You see?
I did not argue with you about it.
I know, and that's what makes me furious. I don't like to win without a fight.
And then, Bella, while you were gone, you had a long-distance call from Berlin. They said you know who it was.
Oh, right! Thank you, Fonz. Max, this is not the first call you've had from Berlin.
Georg, you know I have no clue. Convictions, how can I help if others do?
The Germans have promised not to invade Austria. Max knows that.
Then why does he bother to answer those calls from Berlin?
Because if they decide to break their promise, I would like to have some friends among them.
Naturally.
Oh, so you agree.
Georg, think of it like this. A man is on his deathbed and they're giving him last rites. They ask him, do you renounce the devil and all his works? And he says, at this moment, I prefer not to make any enemies.
If they were to invade us, would you defy them?
Yes. Do you realize what would happen to you? To your property?
To your children?
To everybody close to you? To Elsa? To me? And what would you do if they come? What any person with any sense would do. Sit tight and wait for it all to blow over. And you think it will?
One thing's for sure, nothing you can do will make any difference.
Look so serious, Stormy. Sit down, take the world off your shoulders, relax.
Only saying that you cannot simply give up. Not defeat the line by putting your head to it.
Sir, your call from Berlin?
In the lion's mouth.
Tell them I'll call him back.
You might as well take them.
Go.
Georg, I feel I know where things are going. Can't you see things my way?
No. Not if you're willing to see things their way.
There's one thing you do better here than you do in Vienna. Your sunsets, I'm going to miss them.
Captain! Oh, I beg your pardon.
Maria! Georg never told me Fräulein Marie was back. I'm delighted.
Thank you. Captain, the children wanted to know if they could take a holiday from your lessons tomorrow, so that we could go on a picnic.
Yes, I don't mind.
Thank you. I'm sure that would make them very happy. And if I may be permitted to wish you happiness as well, Frau Schrader, Captain, the children have told me that you are going to be married.
Oh, I'm afraid the children are wrong. Georg, if I'm to get back to Vienna, I'd better start packing.
If you feel you must, I will tell Franz to have you already.
I can do that. It isn't him. Goodbye, Maria.
I'm sorry if I said something I should not have said.
You did say something wrong, but you said it at the right time.
The children had told me that you were going to marry Frau Schrader.
We found that we just could not go the same way. That door is shut.
Sister Margarita always says that when God shuts a door...
I know. He opens a window. Fräulein Maria, why did you run away to Vienna? What made you come back?
Mother Abba says you need to look for your life.
Often when you find it, you don't recognize it.
No.
One day, all of a sudden, it just stands before you. I look at you now and I realize this is not something that has just happened. I've known it deep inside for some time. You knew it too. Who told you?
Nikita, you were dancing that night.
She was quite right too. It was not just any ordinary dance.
I haven't danced that way since I was a very little girl.
And when you were a very little girl, but a very little boy, it was... It's quite different too, isn't it? Take you anywhere you want to go. Give you anything you wish.
I don't want anything. Everything I can wish for is right here.
You know those two want to get together sometime.
Who?
Your mother Abbess and Brigitte. Fräulein Maria, is there someone I should go to ask about Mary?
Why don't we ask each other?
Thank you.
finally. We ask that you all quickly make your way upstairs to the Montfort Academy Chapel, where the wedding ceremony will commence. We are looking forward to seeing all of you there.
Thank you.
Children! Children, come quick! Children, look! The Cultivar Festival, 1989. The Von Trapp Singers.
Uncle Max, does Father know about this?
Brigida, don't you trust me?
No.
What do you think?
Uncle Max, do you know when they will be back from their honeymoon?
Not in time for the festival, I'm afraid.
Yeah. Look what I have here.
That's Father's luggage.
All that noise you make in the morning, Eddie is hearing you sing.
You're just in time to hear us sing. Look, Father, we're singing the Cultivar Festival Friday night.
Max.
Georg! I've been waiting just to talk with you about this.
Not just something you can talk with me after.
Children,
look what we found.
The Von Trapp family does not sing in public.
But if they make people happy?
It is out of the question.
Georg, it's for Austria.
There is no Austria.
Will the transfer of power happen peacefully? We should at least be grateful for that.
Grateful.
Maria, you have to convince her that he's pretending over these people before you're all in danger. He has to compromise.
Max, I cannot ask Georg to be less than what he is.
Then I'll talk to him. If these children do not perform at the festival, it will be a reflection on Austria. And it won't do me any good either.
Maria! I've always known you loved us children. Now, I know you love Father too.
I do, Lisa. I love him very much. What is he doing?
This came while we were away. Germany has offered us a commission.
Father, what's happened?
While we were away, the German government took control of Austria. Now they want me to command a ship in their navy.
What will you do?
I can't just brush this aside. It would be a relief to know that my family is safe, but it also means...
Georg, whatever you decide will be my decision.
No, I can't do this.
Of course not.
I'll have to get out of Austria. But we can't just pack up and leave all at once. They'll be watching us. We need time.
Sir, Herr Zellert is here to see you.
Thank you. Please bring him down. Give us any time.
We have to make time.
Stormtroopers. This is just what I was worried about, Maria.
Max, stay with Georg. Liesel, I need the children. Quickly.
You need to be careful now, Max. Keep your head out.
Don't I always?
Captain Manson, Admiral von Schreiber of the Navy of the Third Reich.
Admiral von Schreiber, may I present to you Herr Detweiler, Max, I believe you know Herr Zeller. Would you gentlemen care to sit down?
We are here on business.
Captain von Trapp.
I'm going to be performing in the Cultivar Family Festival this Friday night. See, here in the program.
It's run through the Ministry of Education and Culture.
Friday night. This is Wednesday. That's only a matter of 2 days. It might still be possible for him to report to Bremerhaven on Monday.
Admiral?
Is there a telephone I can use?
This way, Admiral. I'll show it to you. Now, I don't know what my voice
It says here only the names of the children.
It says the Von Trapp family singers, sir, and I, head of the Von Trapp family.
It's hard to believe Captain Von Trapp, you singing in a concert.
You may believe what you wish, Ezra.
It doesn't say here what you are going to sing. What are you going to sing, Captain?
It is your privilege to come and hear us at the concert, sir.
I'd like to hear you sing now. Sing what you are going to sing. Sing!
A deer, a female deer, gray, a drop.
Thank you.
except of course we do not know what that conclusion is going to be. Our judges are currently putting their heads together to come to their final decision. In the meantime, I think there should be an audible. It seems that this may be the last opportunity that the Von Trapps have to sing together for a long time. I have just received word that the Captain Von Trapp leaves immediately after this for his new command in the Naval Forces of the 3rd Reich. A guard of honor has just arrived to escort him to his position in Bremerhaven. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the family Von Trapp gets word.
Outrageous.
Abbey has always been a place of sanctuary.
Not with these people. This is the third time they've searched the Abbey. That's why we put you out here, in the garden. They always check the inside, never the outside.
Isn't this God's house?
Shh! Yes? We must all be very, very quiet. I'll let you know when they've gone.
After they've gone, can we go home?
Shh. No, darling. We've got a long drive ahead of us.
Liesel! We have to stay close to one another.
Joy and be led forth with peace, and the mountains and the hills shall bring